Jesus died so we might live. Amen. Our text will be from the Gospel, from St. Luke 20, verses 9 through 20, dear friends in Christ. As children, we have big dreams. I want to play in the Final Four. I'm going to swim in the Olympics. I'm going to be a doctor when I grow up. Someday, I will be the president. Now, most of those dreams do not come true. Life goes differently than we had planned. The gifts and ability that God gives us do not match our desires. At some point, those dreams we had as kids get shattered. You don't see me playing point guard for the Lakers, do you? You see, the parable of the vineyard reminds us that the dream envisioned is not always the dream fulfilled. Shattered dreams rebuilt. Like the tenants in the parable, we may have our own dream. The tenants did not want to give the fruit to the owner. They had a nice arrangement going on here, a solid future, secure employment provided by the owner, who set everything up, and of course, the owner had a right to his share. He sent servants. He even sent his son, but the tenants respond with hatred. They want the inheritance, and so they are going to have to kill the son. They were dreaming big dreams, getting the son out of the way would pave the way to the goods. They kill him. Will this make their dream come true? We have dreams. Dreams for our future. Dreams for our children, dreams for ourselves. Is there a grudge you dream of letting go? Do you dream of a day when you have no more problems with your child? Do you lie awake at night wishing your marriage could be like it was years earlier? Are you dreaming of a day when your pride doesn't always get in the way of your behavior? You see, the text shatters the tenant's dreams and maybe ours. The master comes to destroy those servants. That will shatter their dreams. What else could they possibly expect? The stone crushes those upon whom it falls. Those tenants cannot have it their way. No inheritance, no vineyard, no future. Many of you probably know the tenants represent in the parable the Jewish leaders. Jesus is declaring how God will shatter their evil dreams. The temple will be destroyed. Jerusalem, the headquarters of the establishment, will fall as well. And the way they envisioned it, them in charge, enjoying the adoration of the people, will be no more. Repent? Will they turn away from their evil dreams? No, it wasn't in their plans. They will cling to their dream and still try to get their inheritance. They will kill the son, but he will be raised after 3 days. The temple will be restored, but it won't be like it was before. A new king is crowned, but he bleeds and he suffers for the people. All this may shatter our dreams. As we get closer to the cross, it does not allow for things to be my way. It does not allow for dreams to be self-centered. The cross changes the picture. You see, dreams do get shattered. At some point, I knew a 5'9 white guy was not going to make it to the pinnacle of the basketball world. Others found not enough speed in their swimming stroke. Not enough votes even for president of the freshman chess club. Or how about freezing while dissecting a frog? How could they ever be a doctor? But dreams can be transformed and rebuilt. The dreams can change to fit the gifts of each of us. A doctor becomes a social service agency director and binds the wounds of the downtrodden. Swimming in the Olympics becomes teaching swimming at the local Y. President becomes leading your town against unfair taxation. A trip to the Final Four becomes seeing your four kids that you raised marry faithful Lutheran spouses and begin their own Christian families. In doing so, there is fulfillment. See, rather than being swept away, these shattered dreams are rebuilt. In death, there is life. The cross was God's plan from all eternity, and it must shatter us. It shatters our pride. It shatters our grudges. It transforms our children and our marriages. The cross gives us life. Christ has become our cornerstone, and from that stone he builds us up to be his church. We are being transformed into what God dreamed us to be. Last weekend, Holden and I worked the concessions for the girls' state basketball tournament finals at Redburn Arena. Saturday night was the championship game, and we had to stand nearest the majority of fans. He and I were both working the window when halftime came and a mob of humans came at us. We just kept working, and in the midst of the chaos and barely noticeable to us, some of his teammates came from another stand to help us out. Everyone got what they needed in about a 10-minute period. There was no complaining. There was work to be done, and we accomplished it, thank God, rather smoothly. That's a good picture of the Lord's church upon which you and I have been built. We get to see God's mission and be about his work with others in mind, and not ourselves, not our pride. He allows us to bear fruit, and he rebuilds our dreams. Dreams that are God-centered and other-centered rather than self-centered. Amen.